the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name. For you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second book of Kings. Sennacherib, king of Assyria, sent envoys to Hezekiah with his message. Thus shall you say to Hezekiah, king of Judah, do not let your God on whom you rely deceive you by saying that Jerusalem will not be handed over to the king of Assyria. You have heard what the kings of Assyria have done to all other countries. They doomed them. Will you then be saved? Hezekiah took the letter from the hand of the messengers and read it. Then he went up to the temple of the Lord, and spreading it out before him, he prayed in the Lord's presence. O Lord, God of Israel, enthroned upon the cherubim, you alone are God over all the kingdoms of the earth. You have made the heavens and the earth. Incline your ear, O Lord, and listen. Open your eyes, O Lord, and see. Hear the words of Sennacherib, which he sent to taunt the living God. Truly, O Lord, the kings of Assyria have laid waste the nations and their lands and cast their gods into the fire. They destroyed them because they were not gods, but the work of human hands, wood and stone. Therefore, O Lord, our God, save us from the power of this man, that all the kingdoms of the earth may know that you alone, O Lord, are God. Then Isaiah, son of Amos, sent this message to Hezekiah. Thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, in answer to your prayer for help against Sennacherib, king of Assyria, I have listened. This is the word of the Lord has spoken concerning him. She despises you, laughs you to scorn, the virgin daughter Zion. Behind you, she wags her head, daughter Jerusalem. For out of Jerusalem shall come a remnant, and from Mount Zion survivors. The seal of the Lord of hosts shall do this. Therefore, thus says the Lord concerning the king of Assyria, he shall not reach this city, nor shoot an arrow at it, nor come before it with a shield, nor cast up siege works against it. He shall return by the same way he came, without entering the city, says the Lord. I will shield and save this city for my own sake and for the sake of my servant David. That night, the angel of the Lord went forth and struck down 185,000 men in the Assyrian camp. So Sennacherib, the king of Assyria, broke camp and went back home to Nineveh. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God upholds his city forever.
God upholds his city forever.
Great is the Lord and holy to be praised in the city of our God. His holy mountain, fairest of heights, is the joy of all the earth.
God upholds his city forever.
Mount Zion, the recesses of the north, is the city of the great king. God is with her castles. Renowned is he as a stronghold.
God upholds his city forever.
O God, we ponder your mercy within your temple. As your name, O God, so also your praise reaches to the ends of the earth. Of justice, your right hand is full.
God upholds his city forever. Please all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not give what is holy to dogs, or throw your pearls before swine, lest they trample them underfoot and turn and tear you to pieces. Do to others whatever you would have them do to you. This is the law and the prophets. Enter through the narrow gate, for the gate is wide and the road broad that leads to destruction, and those who enter through it are many. How narrow the gate and constricted the road that leads to life, and those who find it are few." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
There is this renewal movement or group, a charismatic group called Focolare Movement, a group founded by Chiara Lubich. And of all the lessons that she gave to her members or to this group, one of the things that she thought was the call for reciprocal love. They call it in Italian l'amore reciproco. Having felt a concrete care from one person, you can also give the same care to others. Kung nabusog ka, magpabusog ka din ng iba. Kung ikaw ay nakapagbigay ng respeto sa iba, magagawa mo ding rumispeto sa iba at makatanggap din ng respeto sa mga tao. We continue to hear the gospel from Jesus's Sermon on the Mount. And part of today's gospel is the known golden rule. Do to others whatever you would have them do to you. Simple po itong tawag na ito, pero madalas po nating makalimutan o maharap ang katotohanan nito kada araw. This golden rule is a concrete way of expressing reciprocal love. People express their gratitude to you because they experienced a grateful person from you. People are lending a hand to us because they felt a generous person from then on from you. Maayos tayong kinakausap ng tao dahil naramdaman nila na maayos tayong kausap marahil no mga unang pagkakataon o unang engkwentro natin sa kanila. On the one hand, this might be the problem today. Gusto natin na galangin tayo. Gusto natin na ibigin tayo. Tratuhin tayo na mabuti. Sabihan tayo ng magagandang bagay. Pero baka hindi naman tayo gumagalang. Baka hindi naman po tayo umiibig. Hindi naman tayo nagtatrato ng mabuti sa iba. Hindi naman tayo nagsasabi ng magaganda sa iba. Instead of doing to others whatever you would have them do to you, we treat them in just the opposite way. We treat them badly, resulting to some bad results or maybe expressions afterwards. Reciprocal love has been the heart of God. God loves so we can love Him and we can love others. God cares so that we can care for others and care as well for God. God is gracious so that we can be gracious to others and also be gracious to God. Every day is a chance for us to do better and to do good. Baka kaya tayo hindi minamahal o hindi ginagalang o hindi ginagawa ng mabuti dahil hindi muna natin na ipapakita. Show your goodness so that goodness can be true to us.
Please all stand.
Christ promises that the narrow gate leads to life. Let us come to our Heavenly Father with the trust and confidence of the prayer our Lord taught us. For every petition, we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of the church may guide the flock to the door that leads to life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as a community, we may treat one another with respect, consideration, and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may carry out God's will by our compassionate dealings with others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick, and those suffering from various illnesses may find strength and healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may be raised with Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass, our prayers for one another, and the prayers of our brothers and sisters joining us through social media. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, create within us sincerity of heart so that we may love and respect others as you treasure them. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please all stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, the Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please all stand.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.